Hello and welcome back to Shire Farm and the On the Map Challenge. We started early this morning just before 6 making up our feed to ensure that our cows were well fed. They are stocked up. They are overflowing with manure. We need to do something about that. But last night we managed to get another 2 loads of wood chips done. This one I've just finished off this morning. To get this sold, and in looking after our cows we also made over 30,000 of milk sales from each of our cow pens, which is very nice. So we'll get this sold, and today we need to finish off filling our silage clamp. We're going to try and get started on filling the clamp down by the BGA, and I think we're going to set off some workers to plow up some fields just so that we're not overrun with that in the winter, because we've got quite a few new fields now that need sorting out, turning over. So we'll be getting them set up and doing things there. So let's crack on with it. 39 grand pretty much. Good way to start the day. Let's go. So to try and manage the manure situation a little bit, rather than just sitting there wasting, so we're wasting it, it's waste, but it doesn't, you know, replenish once we've filled. Each pasture or each pen holds 100,000 litres each, so it fills this perfect. Normally once we've emptied it, it instantly starts to respawn some more, but that's okay. So we're going to put some more of this in the BGA. It only holds like 30,000 litres, so we'll put some in here, and the rest I'll quickly shoot down to the grain elevator and we'll sell there. I'm hoping there's a bit of a shortcut driving around here. I was hoping we wouldn't have to go back into the map and take out any more bushes, but I should have put in a little entrance there. Perhaps if I just mark up a track down the top here, because this is much quicker than driving around the outside of the map to cut through our farm. I think there's about 7,000, so we'll probably get about 29,000 litres in. But we're going to be looking to come up here quite a bit today. Get some silage in one of them. They probably hold a mammoth amount. But we can get that in there, and then we can start to try and sell it in here. You see, we've still got a little bit in there. Unload. As I say, it won't take it all, but that'll do. It's enough. It's topped it up a bit. We haven't really got anything else. The slurry, although there are slurry fills, we do tend to use that a little bit easier, because I can do that with workers still. I will take the main road back. We'll take the road down. I'll get this sold. It won't be for a lot. How much I don't know, but you'll see. We're at 1269, so you'll join me back at the farm as we try and gather up some grass to fill our clamp. I almost forgot straight away I was going to plough some fields up, so I've jumped in the 960, and we're going to head over to field 25, I believe it is. Set a worker up to plough that up. Just gonna come in the wrong one again. Just gonna grab some petrol, some gas, some diesel, however it is you like to refer to it. Our production site. That is making us some money, by the way. As you can see, we're nearly on 1.3 million. It is making us plenty of money. Not everyone comes to the garage that route. It's that special route, our private route in. How expensive do you think this is going to be? We're rolling. I've got my dodgy accelerator. $400. We do have gas at gas. Yeah, it's good. We do have petrol at the farm, but I forgot to top up before we left. There we go. Right. So they've just gone right up to the top end. This isn't a path here. I still need to take out them two trees, possibly one more of those down there. That one might stay. Possibly move two there. Quite a few still to go. Busy, busy. And then, really, we need to get rid of those ones. They need to get gone. Already set me route up, as you can see. And off they go. Let them do their thing, they'll plough that in. Once they're finished there, we'll move them over, plough in the dead corn. And that'll be those two ready. And now that that's all set up, sold and ready, everyone's going, we can get started on filling the rest of our clamp. I think they hold a million. There's 600,000 in there. Depending on compaction, it's not always easy to get the million in. Plus, on that clamp, it clashes with the manure pit. Just from where the manure pit trigger is, we can't put any grass down company chaff in there. So, this will probably be the last one that goes in there. And then, then I'll be running it up to the BGA. Before running it to the BGA, I will switch over to the fast track, because that'll move us quicker. We'll probably run with the real speed as well. That'll allow us to do 22 with the New Holland. With the fast track, we might be able to go a bit quicker. So we'll see about that. But anyway, it now gives me a chance to say, I hope you're all well, enjoying what you're doing. Again, as before, I'm recording this before I go away. I'm hoping to give myself about a 2-week buffer on return, so that I can, you know, take a bit of time and get into the content, not having that mad rush to jump on and record as soon as we get home, although I will be jumping on and recording because I will be, surprise surprise, on Starfield. And but I want to make sure that the farming is here and not neglected while I enjoy something else for a bit. And we're doing well, we're making good progress here. I mean, we've got enough money, I could buy up more fields, but we're just not in a position to be able to work them at the minute. Still trying to run it like it's somewhat of a farm all by myself, which is a challenge in itself. Like I said, we're going to try and sort something out auto drive wise to get some routes for selling. Like, we could have this set up on auto drive, mark up the fields and do what you have to do, sort of thing. But that takes time, and at the minute I just don't have that time before I go away. So maybe in that buffer that I get in when we return from our vacation, I can try and do some of that, mark up roads, you know, major fields and stuff. So there is hope, there is hope. But yeah, certainly silage and stuff. Then I gotta think how I'm gonna empty those big clamps up at the BGA. We'll probably have to get some sort of augers and what the other things, the conveyors. I haven't done anything with conveyors in a long time. We've done a little bit with augers on UMRV. Hopefully on my return we can get that started up as well. Get that re-going again. So I absolutely love that map. I've had so much fun just driving around and exploring that map while we've been contracting our butts off there too. So hopefully there's lots I want to do. Oh, as always, like I always say, there's so much I want to do. There's just not enough time in the day to do everything. But on the return, our eldest boy, he starts back at nursery, so that'll free up a few hours a day to maybe squeeze in a little extra editing or a little extra recording, which then frees up a little bit more time in the evening to get more stuff done once he's gone to bed and everyone else is happy. Getting that balance right is the challenge. I was saying to Simu Dad not that long ago, that I am quite fortunate in the fact that I, you know, am a stay-at-home dad. My partner goes out and she earns the bread, and I don't have that hassle that a lot of people that are trying to do content creation, trying to do YouTube, trying to do Twitch streaming, Kick, whatever is your platform. A lot of people still have, you know, family, work, and then this, whereas I just have, you know, family and this. So I do try to get out as much as I can. Just at the minute, we have quite a demand on family. That's all. But yeah, this is going to take a while. We're only halfway through. I'll bring you guys back once we're full and we're getting in the clamp, or filled the clamp. So that's just under 800,000 litres. I don't know what happened to a few thousand litres overnight. Where did it go? Has it spilled out the back? No, there's nothing down here. It's just not gone in. Perhaps it's seeped out somewhere else. A little bit of silage leakage. But yeah, 771,539 litres. But this area here, we can't fill. So we've only really got this little bit here into the front. So I am going to say that is our clamp full for now. That is plenty. Absolutely plenty. Switch over. I'm going to show you our naughty magic toy that we use now. Just over here. This is our compactor. And it is... I mean, they come even bigger. But this is 100 times the compaction without being 100 times the weight, if that makes sense. So I don't have to spend a whole day normally trying to roll this. Drive over a couple of times and we should be pretty good. So then as we come forwards, you see that rate going up nice and quick. That's why I like to pack as well with, a nice flat top if I can. I spend quite a bit of time puffing my trailers up to the back. Because then if you do have a clamp that you can fill properly, then you get a beautiful finish on it. I like a flat top on a clamp. This one, we didn't do quite so well on. Try and get that off. There we go. So we're going to switch over to, like I say, the JCB for the fast track. Have we got a spot to park the New Holland? Now we've got all these extra tractors. We've got a bloody great Fendt here as well. The Fendt will be going over with the Maestro once we've built a farm area by our root crop spot. Our root crop spot. Yeah, bloody rolling forward all the time. Have to remember to pump the accelerator to stop. Right. JCB turn. On the other hand, don't have to press anything to start up. We got... did we get about half that? What was left on that one meadow in there? So I think we'll get another full trailer off that meadow. Run that up to the VGA. Then, have we got enough space? Yes. And then we'll clear the small one. I feel like I've been more productive if I get some of them clear. We'll clear a small one. And then the next one, or the last one, will be at the back. We've got two small ones, so we'll see how that goes. We may even have to order in some more silage additive, because we have been using silage additive. I forgot to say last time out, that should be shown. Oh, I turned it off. that should be shown in the fast, in the time lapse. I was going to say in the fast track, in the time lapse from the last. The last little pickup, we time-lapsed it. I don't know why I'm losing my words. So I am going to use real speed just so we can get this done, because I don't want to be doing this for 2 days. I probably will still have to do some tomorrow, but I don't have to, you know, for 2 whole days. But I shall speed this up as well. We'll have a little time-lapse of this and try and catch me running through the farm and getting some in the clamp. But since it is a lot of what we've already done and what we did last time out, I'm going to try and cut it out. Because last time, it took all my might in editor to get that episode under 60 minutes. I didn't think I was going to get it there. It was a 3-hour recording and I just struggled to get it down, but we did. So I don't want to have that fight again. So I want to shut up and we'll go fill the BJ clamp. Never stop, I'll get it if I want it. Gotta make to myself a promise. I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top. Yo, no, I ain't the type to give up. If I do something, man, I do it till I get what I want. I turn a business out of nothing into something I love. I got a poker face, but honestly, I'm not one to bluff. I flip a switch, never miss, man, I always stay up. Don't let them see you, bitch, always have a plan to stay tough. This life ahead of you ain't easy, it was built to be rough. But that's what makes a personality is tragedy, bruh. So keep your head on your shoulders. Now we ain't out here moving rocks, we out here moving boulders. Now we ain't getting posterized, we out here making posters. And we ain't got nothing to hide, we move forward like soldiers. You better wake up for the pay stub, or you'll pay up. Don't make love to the game, bro. Fuck the game up. Well, it's now coming up for 8:30, and I think this is our 5th load, so it should be, I think, a million litres in the clamp. I'll drive across the road so you can see what we've got left. At least I think to here would get us another load. These are just partials, so we've probably got another 300,000 litres as well. So that's quite a bit. I wasn't able to get it all in, even running real speed at like 24 miles an hour. It still took all day and we're still not done. Now, our worker that was doing the ploughing, I set them up wrong. They were on start at the nearest point, but their actual start point was in the middle of the field, so they just did the last headland and sat there for most of the day. So they're actually still ploughing. We should have had both of those fields ploughed. We've only got one of them done. Hopefully I'll get that right next time as we move them over in the morning to plow the other field. But we'll get this in the clamp. Just made this feel a long one. It's been a long time since I've done pretty much one job all day. We're nearly out of fuel as well. I have to remember to fill up before we head back out. But tomorrow, we'll make sure the cows are topped up. We will make sure they've got some bedding. We'll go over. We'll top up the sheep. I think they'll need some bales. I'll probably need water as well. I wouldn't be surprised if that's run out. We'll do all that before we get stuck into running the last of it. Just to break the day up, if anything, just for me. Just so that this this 3+ hours that this is going to be isn't just spent doing this. Now, I was driving through and unloading it. We got stuck a few times. As you can see, it's a little bit heapy. Going around the other side and back in. Now, if we had a loader over here, we could sort of flatten that out and smooth it, and I'd be able to back up onto it a bit better, but we're just sort of forcing ourselves up and on. You know, with the sheer quantities, obviously, that we're getting, 200,000 litres at a time, it's just so much that comes out. we just pretty much force ourselves up. We'll see if we can get a fill level. Now that's as far as it wants to come for me. And we'll just roll forward now. And again, we're not worried about the compaction. We'll come up with our weighted compactor, I guess. Once we get too high, we'll be able to drive off. There we go. So what's that? We'll be sitting there, it'll tell us. Just under, I don't know where we keep losing a few thousand litres, but we do. But that's just under 1 million litres in there. And it's nowhere. That must be like a 2 million litre clam. Must be. Right, let's head home and start afresh in the morning with a few different jobs. So morning has broken. 27,000 from one milk sale, 16,000 from the other. Don't know why we get such disparaging amounts. I mean, the feed is still pretty good. We're going to top it up. The feed's still pretty good. They've got straw. Well, that one's produced manure. This one doesn't seem to have produced any manure for me. They got straw? They have got straw. What's going on in here? Oh, there it is. Half full. There we go. Just didn't want to pop in. Fair enough. Right, so I need a tractor. We'll use the lovely New Holland. Our new toy. Hope everyone's enjoying the new toy. T7. Is that 315? T7315 STV Modern. And we got Blue Power Edition. Do you remember back when Blue Power Edition was like a PlayStation exclusive on console, wasn't it? Was that for like the premium edition stuff? FS17 possibly? Right. I think there was already a little bit of TMR in there, and after I finished filling, I'd chucked in an extra bale. See if we can get near the edge and scoop that in. So again, it won't take two full loads. That's all right. Oh, I also forgot to cover our clamp, didn't I? While we're out here. There we go. Let's get that fermented. Not that we're in a rush. But, let's have it done. June 2. Ooh. We'll go and check on our worker as well. That's doing the ploughing. Get them shifted over to the other field. Get that back on track. As you can see, we start at 6 again. Not sure 100% on all the jobs we need to do, other than what we've sort of said, like finishing off things. I'm sure there are other jobs. I mean, we can get started on muck spreading, some grass. We can get a worker slowly spreading. I do need to take out at least another, 10 trees, probably more. 10, 12 trees. So that can be done this afternoon if we've time. If not, again, that'll be a in-between episodes job, getting the trees cut. Be nice to give that a rest. I'd rather go and bale another field or something and cut more trees. But we don't need to spread on that meadow there in front of us and to our right, because that one is going to get ploughed in. I'm not sure how much you're going to need here. I don't think either one of them needs more than about 10, 12,000 litres, so... should only take about half. While that's going in, we will get some straw bales out ready, because the unload does take a while. Straw bales, and we'll get two, because then they'll come in the how I want them. There we go. We'll have four. I think they'll take two each. Oh wow, that is taking it all. Might have to cut it short. I am. Because we'll feed them again in the morning. And there's more than enough there to get them through the night. I just want to make sure they stay topped up. Got a bit naughty and got a bit lapsed with it, didn't I? Didn't I, so I should say. Bloody deny. Deny what? Alright, so while that's going in, we'll jump back into the telehandler. Telehandler? Wheel loader. Perhaps we should have a telehandler as well. Got 1.4 million, by the way, people. 1.4 million. We are rich as hell. Still 578,000 litres in there. That was like 750. So we're getting through it a lot quicker. A lot quicker when you think the first clamp had just over 500,000 in it, and it took us years to get through. This one, a lot quicker. We're not going to use the straw blower this time. Although I think there is some bales in the straw, or there are some bales in the straw blower. In our lovely Robert straw blower or bale shredder, however you wish to refer to it. Again, we take these long ways on just because if not they pop back in. So I think then I'll take them both. If it doesn't, it'll take it overnight anyway. Nope, took two. That's good. And then probably tomorrow I'll have another 200,000 litres. No, actually, it was only 50 in there each, weren't it? So, no, 50 was the amount, yeah. So, yeah, we'll have another 100,000 litres of manure to sell. Unless we spread loads of it. And I won't worry about spreading the two big fields there. Those meadows, I probably, well, I will do it. I'm going to plough them both up. I'm going to plough them both up when I join them and do the whole lime and everything treatment on them. Lovely job. Right, so next up, sheep. We're probably overdue buying another sheep pen or two just for the fun of filling it up. And wool does us wonders. Oh, come on. Don't be a bugger. There we go. Oh, no. Why are they stuck to each other? Let's have a little look at this situation here. You swine. Come on. Be a good bale. There we go. Right. Whoa. The sticky accelerator is catching us out. Yeah, I think we can put another row in at the below them before we start bringing them closer. It'll just be crazy. The lag will probably go insane, but it'll be fun, I think. Oh, it don't look like they need that much, actually. I did chuck some bales on here. I think I did say, didn't I? I put some bales on. Not even sure if that... There we go. Careful not to knock. Not they'll stop filling. I'm quick enough, I might be able to catch them before they fall. There we go. Smooth. So all the others are empty. That's why we've not got as much wool. I did say a few episodes ago I think they need feeding. But one of them has loads still. Perhaps that has more lambs in than the others. Come on, drop in there. That's it. Right. Let's go get another stack for the bottom row. So they probably all... Not all. Well, yeah, I could just put one bale in front of them and leave them again for a bit longer. We won't, but oh, I've got my lights on, but terrible. I always have my lights on. I do like to have my beacon and my work light on. So maybe go a little bit higher. That's better. A little slower pace for the second half of the episode. Although the first half, you know, first day should be pretty sure, I think. All going well in editing. Sometimes the recording sessions for these are so long. It's as if I record them over multiple days. Because I forget so much all the time. Right, let's move them down. I'm sure this is a strange way to do this, but makes a change for me just running down carrying big old bales, doesn't it? Right, put that one in there. Ooh, don't knock that. I'm more worried about knocking a pallet than I am running over a sheep. Let's go grab two more so we can pop in here. That'd be more than we probably need, but so we can leave the bale and they'll eat it. So yeah, we got this meadow cleared, we got the small one that we're going to plough in cleared, the two out front are done, the big one, and then we've just got, like I say, the even bigger one. We've just got like, I think we've got about 300,000 litres on it. Here's two that we just conveniently have stacked. And Now, if I remember rightly, we can't attach that. We might be able to attach the trailer because we've got that weight on the back there now. It might allow us to, although we won't have the proper hose connections, I don't think, it still might let us work it. We're not running manual attach or anything like that. Just drive past it, knock it in. Beautiful stuff. So we'll see if we can get the water on there. If not, we'll just have to come back with another tractor. It didn't connect. I think I remember trying to connect it before. No, not connecting. But it did connect. I know that now. We haven't anything smaller, so we've got the T7 on the water bowser now. I can find the water trigger. Here we are. That's going to get annoying. But we've not been able to stop where I want to all the time. Well, unless that was it. Perhaps that was all it needed. Yep, not come back up. Water triggers can be finicky sometimes. Didn't get anything on that one. But they must need water. They must. There we go. Seems to have a quick unload, but it takes forever to fill. Anyway, I shall get these filled up, because this isn't interesting to watch. Me rocking backwards and forwards, me pissing accelerator sticks. Yeah, we'll get these done, and we'll get back to some more jobs. The worker has been moved over to plough the other field, or the other meadow. Other field? Other field, yeah. They've been moved over. But I will need to go around the edges and tidy them up, because there's bits that they miss, but mainly from where sort of the old growth overlaps the outside of the field boundary. So that just needs to be topped up. Or topped up, touched up, while we're topping up. Anyway, yeah, I'll shut up, get this done, and we'll roll into a different job. And while we go out and try and finish off the rest of the grass collection, we get a worker on. I wasn't going to spread this, was I? What a fool. Never mind, it'll be spread. Perhaps we'll just plough up the back and the joining bit. That'll be enough for us. They've missed the first inroad, haven't they, again? Never mind. I'm not very good at setting up my workers to ensure that they hit the start points I want them to. So I should imagine they're just going to do a loop around and then stop. But never mind. I'll keep an eye on it. But I'm going to spend probably the next few hours in-game getting this picked up and delivered down into the BGA. Once this is all in, I shall bring you back again. But this is what I'll be doing for a bit. See you in a second. There's not as much left on that field, or on that meadow, sorry, as I thought. We've just dropped off a full load, and I thought I'd better make sure we've got some petroleum. I think all I now have to do is drive up to it. That's all. There we go. This one, obviously we don't pay for it, we brought it. We ordered it in a long time ago. I do fill up from this every now and then. I just don't always show it, because it's normally at the end of the day or at the start. I thought I'd show you that we do these jobs. Stick the accelerator's going to pull us away. Right, let's get it shut. Got 4,000 litres still. I think I've actually topped it up twice since we've done a restart. We do get through a lot of diesel. But we've probably got two and a half rows left to get, but we're going to get it, we're going to bring it in. Since we've got to plough it up and do, we might as well. Might as well clear it. Again, it's midday. Getting through our day. If we weren't running the real speed, you know, the double speed, pretty much, nearly triple speed, I should imagine, at the minute, this would have took us a couple of days. We'd have still needed to do this come September, I guess. Longer, because we'd have all the other things. We've got harvests to get ready for and replants, and I need to go and check on the olives. Lin Yuen, channel member, has been in touch and got in touch with me on Discord as well about a mod pack that would help with maintaining the olive groves and the grapevines, and also recommended, much like Disturbed has with a few other things, auto drive. He says if you use the pack that he's recommended, there's going to be a link to it, and then set out the auto drive route, it will make it a lot quicker. So we'll see when I can get round to trying to work some auto drive in. That will be definitely be something we look into, especially if we've got to have grapes and olives. I'll try and get the first harvest in myself, so that we can say we've done one full round where it's all me. And then after that, however many years left we have, we can try and see if we can get auto drive to do it. He says it's perfect. You know, you drive a nice smooth, as long as you set yourself up a nice smooth route through it, then it'll just go off and follow that. And I guess that's my challenge, isn't it? Setting up the smooth route. But we've only got 32,000 metres here. So I can't remember what that gives us. Does that give us, this might bring us to about 1.2 million, is it? Or will this bring us to a million metres? I tell you, these episodes get so long, I cannot keep track of all the numbers that we check out. Just try and back it in on here. I say not the tidiest, but we've been trying to be quick. Not always worried about how this one looks. We'll just back up a little bit. I say, yeah, it should bring us up to 1.2. Oh, just under 1.2, look. That's a lot. That's a lot of chaff. Certainly for anything that I do. Now, I was wondering whether to just see if we could fill them. Add a little extra to the challenge. Let's see if we can fill both of these. Maybe. I don't know. We're not in desperate need for the digestate. I'll decide. I'm not going to come over with my roller and do it yet. We don't necessarily need to cut as often as we cut, though, so maybe we won't try and fill the clamps. Maybe that can be a very end of series challenge. If we've got enough grass fields, we'll see if we can get it all in there. There were those, well, considering major jobs done. Now I'm going to spend a little bit of time tidying up around this field. I'm going to say it's just where the growth overlaps the recognised field, and you just have to turn on create fields and plow it in if you're finicky like me. I'm sure if you come over with a mulcher or something, it would get rid of it as well. But and these fields along the edge here, we need to, these trees along the edge here, we need to come and get those as well. Once all that's done and once our first beet harvest is in, we'll come and we'll plow those two together and join them with this one, make one massive one. And we'll probably do potatoes, good and better. What am I doing? Yeah, we'll fill this up with potatoes and have a big old potato harvest. We'll probably do it with the other side over there as well. And then once we've had a beet and a potato harvest, we'll fill... excuse me. We'll fill this one and that then long one over there with cotton. And hopefully we'll have a massive cotton harvest. I think it will feel pretty big. That might be the only cotton harvest we do. So we may lease the cotton harvester rather than buy it, if we're only going to use it once. I mean, we've got some equipment now that we don't need anymore. That little equipment that we've got. We've got the roller. We're not rolling fields or the mulcher really. We're not rolling or mulching fields at the moment. We just don't have the time to put that step in. And at the end of the day, it's probably for a total of about, what, 2% yield? And we're not struggling, so it's not really a concern. At the beginning, it was nice to try and get that in, but with only 2 days... per calendar month, it's a little bit tight, to say the least. Come get that little tuft at the end. There's another little tuft on the other side. But yeah, this will now give us, at least when we do course play, this will give us a better recognised field edge. The other side, absolutely fine. I don't think it missed any. It's just on this one. I'm keeping the path down the middle for now. Who knows, there might come a time when we just plough that up as well and combine the whole lot just for convenience. Depends on how many years we have left. Just was one job that's then running in the background. That's sort of what I'm thinking with those type of things. Is that if there's a massive field, then we can put a worker on it, we can put an auger or one, a couple of our big bins on it and let them do their thing. Even if it is for the 2 days, or even for 2 whole months, it'll get done. Again, something that can be played about with, hopefully, with auto drive and horse play and a little bit of unloading or something. Just got a few little tufts over on this side, and then that'll be this field ploughed. So we may do a bit of muck spread. I'm not sure if we do need to, just to use it up. Slurry will only go so far. Well, as is often the case, I've changed my mind and conceded to the fact that I need to get stuck in and removing the trees down here. Oh, we have 2 tractors. I thought I took the tractor off that trailer. I had it. It's because they're all class and they all look the same. So yeah, it's now, what is it now? Nearly 3 o'clock. It takes me, what does it take normally, what, 3 hours? 3.5 hours to, in game, obviously not in real life, in game to break down 4 trees. So before it gets dark at 8, should be able to get rid of 8 if I go at 10, but I will, there we go, I will run a little bit slower once I get going, because I think I want to remove more than 8. I think I need to remove more than 8, more to the point. What's the diesel like in there? That's not doing too bad. That's going to need doing once we've finished all this tree work. So, what did I say I was keeping? I keep that one. And I'm going to take away these. Keep that one. Take away this one. Take away these two. They can go. That one will go. And don't worry about all these trees. Well, do worry about the trees. I am going to replace them. I'm going to have a big tree planting session as well. We'll take away these two as well, and that'll be the first four that can go in. We've got to cut down my stumps at the top. And I wasn't too sure on what I was going to do. Let's get rid of that bit. Yeah, over the other side of that track. I need to make my mind up quick as well. That might be where I plant some more trees. In one of our future meadows, fields, or current ones, you never know. I will replant some trees. We'll replant like a whole forest. We'll have that grow. I need to get that done soon, just so we can see it grow, because it does take years. So we might only see a little bit of growth on it, but will be nice to have. Let's do this. But yeah, since it's just going to be me cutting up these trees, we've done that for like, what, 3 episodes now we've been cutting up trees? Maybe 4. You've seen enough of my frustration this way. Like I keep saying, one day, I do have it in the bag, it's there waiting. We will have a proper forestry series. So I will leave you at this point. And yeah, hopefully, again, I can condense this down. It's not quite a 3-hour episode, because we are going to finish at 3 o'clock instead of like 7 or 8. But yeah, it's still a long one. So hopefully I can condense it down into something remotely entertaining and worthwhile. That's too tall. Yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, give it a big fat thumbs up down below. If you are new to the channel, hit the subscribe button, turn the bell notification on, find out when new videos are going live. As always, comments and feedback down there. You guys have a wonderful day, and hopefully I will see you again very soon. Bye bye.